Hello everyone and welcome back to our YouTube channel. If you are new here, my name is Sasha and I normally do videos with my daughter Arella, who is almost 2 years old. But in today's video, I'm going to be talking about relactation, what it is, and how I relactated at 6 months and then again at 9 months. I decided to stop breastfeeding and I actually stopped producing milk, and I decided again later, like, okay, I really want a breastfeeder. And I think like pumping is a very, very good way to help you bring back your breast milk, and that's exactly what I did. So if you aren't interested in learning how to relactate and how I relactated and the steps I did, then continue watching. Also, if you are new here, I post a lot of motherhood lifestyle videos and I would love for you to join my family and stay updated with videos because I like to share information for mommies and help out in fields like that. So again, if you're new here, hit subscribe and join the channel. Okay, so in today's video, I'm going to be talking about relactation. That is the process of bringing back your breast milk after not breastfeeding for a little while, and you might not have any milk at all, or you might have very little bit. But I learned that you can bring back your breast milk. Some people, they don't even have breast milk. They are adopting kids and they want to breastfeed and they do these steps and they're able to make milk. So I learned that pumping was the number one thing that you could do. Pumping is so important and it becomes pretty tedious because you're pumping around the clock, but it is so worth it because you end up creating so much more milk every single time you pump. And I would get so excited when I would see the milk in the bottles, even just the little splatters when I first started off. It was just really, really exciting for me to be able to give her breast milk again. And I was able to give my daughter breast milk up until a year, a little bit over that, but I would say until a year. I just find that it feels really accomplishing. I felt really sad that I couldn't breastfeed her as long as I wanted to, and we got to enjoy it for a little bit, but I found out that she had a tongue tie, and that is like the little like string in their mouth that causes their tongue to like not latch onto you properly, and they're just not getting enough milk. So she would breastfeed and still be hungry, and I would always kind of wonder like what is going wrong, like I'm not sure. And I would pump and be getting enough milk, so I was kind of confused, and I found that out later on. But yeah, if you guys have any questions about tongue ties, let me know and I can also make a video on that. But back to relaxation, what I did was go on a pumping schedule. So I would be pumping every 2 hours, and I made sure to set my alarm so that I would be pumping. And I did this while my daughter was in her jumper, while I had her on the floor playing, and it was pretty hard to like get up in the middle of the night and pump. But at that point my daughter was still waking up, and so during the middle of the night when she would get up, I would feed her, do what we needed to do, and then go pump. And so I started at 6 months, and I did this by drinking a lot of water. You need to be drinking a lot of water in order to actually create that breast milk, and pumping will stimulate your breast and create that motion of suckling, and it'll eventually work your hormones into creating the milk. I personally also use domperidone. So in Canada, we're allowed to use this medication to help us produce breast milk, and this really, really helped me bring in the breast milk so much faster. So 4 days into pumping, I started seeing so much more progress than I did, because when I was squeezing the nipple, I would see a little bit of milk, and then I didn't see anything in the bottles the first couple of days, and then I finally started seeing milk in the tunnels, and I was like, okay, like I'm gonna keep going. I'm so excited to see how much more milk I'm gonna make. And then I did some more research and found out foods that you can eat that will help create and stimulate more breast milk production. So I found out foods like oatmeal is really good for helping, and I would just be eating a lot more oatmeal and energy bars, things with fiber, and trying to boost up that milk supply. Gatorade and Powerade is another milk boosting supply, milk supply booster. I would just really be upping my foods in like breast milk production things. It really helped. And then I also started taking these vitamins. They were the Nature Path Blessed Thistle and Fenugreek. Yeah, fenugreek capsules, and they were huge pills, like they were horse-sized pills. They kind of tasted pretty earthy, like kind of maple syrup-ish, and I have a very hard time swallowing pills, so it was just really hard and gross for me to like take these pills. But I just knew that the outcome with it would be really beneficial, and so I started taking these vitamins. I believe you take them twice a day, in the morning and then at night. That's what I did. And then you take them with a meal, so just drinking a lot of water, taking your vitamins and then eating your oatmeal, pumping all the time, you'll definitely, definitely see results, and you will see that breast milk production. You will not see this right away. It definitely took me some time before I even started seeing milk in the tunnels of the breast pump, like I said, and you just want to keep going and knowing that it needs to actually be working in like your breast milk tissues before it actually comes out. And you really need to get a good pump when doing this. I personally use the Medela Pump In Style Advanced. This was really good. The suction was amazing. It helped pull out a lot of milk, and within like the first week I started seeing drops in the bottle, and then a month in I started seeing even more milk, and then as more time went on I kept pumping and I kept up to date with like every 2 hours and eating the foods and the vitamins and taking the domperidone, and I just started making so much milk. I eventually started leaking when my baby would cry. I would be out for a certain amount of hours after like time would pass. I would get really engorged and I would really need to pump. I ended up using things like Hakas to like relieve that pressure, and it just really like came in pretty good just because I was keeping up to date with the pumping. And I know it's kind of hard, like especially if your baby is sleeping through the night and having to get up to pump, continue that schedule when your baby would feed as a newborn pretty much, and that's like that 2-hour, 3-hour point. You just want to keep up with pumping and actually stimulating your breast so that you can, you know, get that breast milk. Another good thing too is like massaging your breast while pumping to like get the fat going in the tissues and all the milk hormones going here, and then hand expressing like in the shower. I love doing that because like the hot water and like the pressure, it really helps just get all that milk out. Another thing I read about but I just didn't personally try myself is using the Hakka in the shower with the hot water. This will just get your milk flowing, and it's really good for like getting more milk out so that your body can create more milk. That's the most important thing with this, is that you need to be removing the milk for your body to get the signs that like you want to make more milk, and it will eventually make more. So just make sure that you're pumping every 2 to 3 hours. Don't let 3 hours pass where you're not pumping, and eventually as time goes on and you're making like 4 to 5 ounces or something like that, then more time can pass in between. So like 4 to 5 hours in between pumping, and then go from there, and then you can kind of build a schedule. But in the beginning, you definitely want to be power pumping. So that is pumping like 20 minutes on, taking the pump off for 5 minutes, pumping for 10 minutes, taking it off for 5 minutes, pumping for 10 minutes, taking it off for 10 minutes, and then like doing stuff like that. So you can Google a lot of different power pumping schedules and go from there. I've seen at Walmart, they have lactation cookies, and you can definitely Google a bunch of different recipes and make your own lactation treats and bites so that this will help produce breast milk. Google foods that you like eating and that will help you create more breast milk, so then it'll definitely work all together and help you make that. Speak to your doctor, or if you guys have breastfeeding consultants, they're really good for helping you. That's actually who I found out about the domperidone from. I went to the breastfeeding consultant and I was just trying to find ways on how to breastfeed again. And there is something called like this little tube. I'm not sure what the exact name is, but it's a tube. Eventually, like they can learn how to breastfeed again. We didn't go that far. I just really wanted her to get the breast milk, so I was okay with that. And there is definitely different people you can talk to and ask about the different options you can get wherever you are located and what country you are in. And if you're in Canada, ask about domperidone, and it's really helpful. It helps you make that milk, and I didn't have any side effects with it. Just make sure you're talking to your doctor about the side effects and if it's okay for you to be using, and go from there. That's what I did for pumping, and I just really want to like stress on the main points again, which is 1, pumping; 2, drinking water; 3, eating the foods that help you create that breast milk; 4, stimulating your breast, so hand massaging, hand expressing in the shower, things like that; and 5, eating, I think I said that, if you can, take vitamins and supplements that help with this. So the lactation cookies, the blessed thistle vitamins, fenugreek is really good. I know I've heard it works with some ladies and then others it doesn't. So just see what works for your body and go with that. But the main thing is pumping, and you just want to make sure that you are actually pumping. And if your baby is younger, or even if you just want to enjoy having skin-to-skin contact with your baby, that will give your body the signs that I don't know, something maternal and hormonal is going on, and it will just help you create that milk, especially if your baby is in the soothing suckling stage and they can still kind of like use your nipple as a pacifier. I would definitely recommend doing that. It would help to stimulate your breast and create that breast milk, and that's the goal here. So yeah, I really hope you guys find these tips helpful, and I included these pictures so that you guys can see that I started from nothing and ended up creating about 30 ounces a day, and she was strictly on breast milk after. And then I just decided, like, okay, it's a little bit too much. She was sleeping through the night, and I personally decided, like, I'm content with how much breast milk she has had, and I gave up that way. You can go as long as your body is making the milk, and especially if you do end up getting pregnant again and your body naturally just creates a lot of milk again, then yeah, that's good. You can continue breastfeeding, doing things like tandem feeding and weaning off if you want to, just deciding what works best for you. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed and find these tips helpful. Definitely wishing you luck if you are this far in and looking for tips on how to relactate. It will definitely happen. Just be patient. That's my main thing. It's a little frustrating sometimes, like pumping and not seeing any milk, but just know that eventually there will be milk, and sometimes there will be so much milk that you need to use a second bottle to put it in. So thank you guys so much for watching, and if you haven't already, please check out our other videos. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and follow us on social media. I do post a lot of things on there so that you can keep updated and like future upcoming things that I'm about to share on here. So definitely follow us there. And again, thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye.